Hello friends, in the previous week we understood the concept of Euclid's division lemma, and this week we are going to take our study of real numbers a little further and study the concept of Euclid's division algorithm. But before we start with Euclid's division algorithm, let's first try to understand what is algorithm. Now probably in your computer classes you already know that while creating even a small computer program in any computer language, your teacher gave you a set of steps to follow, which was called algorithm for that particular program. So similarly, in mathematics, you have this Euclid's division algorithm. Probably one of the first algorithms to be even done on a computer. So now, to understand algorithm, let us turn to page number 4 of the textbook. Now on this page, the very first word itself is algorithm, and it says an algorithm is a series of well-defined steps which gives us a procedure for solving a type of problem. And just to the right of this written text you have this picture, and this is the picture of one of the 9th century AD famous Persian mathematician, astronomer, geographer by the name of Muhammad bin Musa al-Khwarizmi. He wrote a treatise on Hindu-Arabic number system in Arabic language, which was translated by the Westerners in Latin in the 12th century with the title Algorithmi de Numero Indorum, which means Algorithmi on the numbers of the Indians in English. So basically the word algorithmi was the Latinization of his name, Al-Khwarizmi. And now a small trivia on this famous man. Did you know that Al-Khwarizmi was the most widely read mathematician in Europe in the late Middle Ages? Try to read more about him, and that will make your study of the topic even more interesting. And now let us get back to Euclid's division algorithm. Euclid's division algorithm is a set of steps which is used to compute the HCF of two given positive integers. Now, before we come to the generalization of this concept, we'll again take up some specific examples with numbers. Now, if you remember in your young days, probably when you were in class 5th, 6th, 7th, you found out the HCF of any two given numbers basically by two methods. So HCF, you found it by two methods. The first method was prime factorization. And the second method was long division method. Now let us try to recall what was the prime factorization method to find the HCF. So for that, let us take the two numbers 4, 55 and 42. First we'll prime factorize 4, 55. So it's 5 into 91. So we round off the prime factor, and this is nothing but 7 into 13. So these are both prime factors. So we can write 455 as 5 into 7 into 13. And then 42 is nothing but 6 into 7. So 7 is prime, and 6 is 2 into 3. So these are prime numbers. So 42 is nothing but 2 into 3 into 7. Now you can clearly see that the highest common factor is nothing but the common factor 7. So the HCF of 455 and 42 is 7 by prime factorization. And now let us take up finding HCF of these two numbers again by long division method. So for the long division, we take 455 to be the dividend and 42 the smaller number to be the divisor, and we divide it. So 42 tens are 420, and we are left with 35. Now in this step, 35 for the next step, 35 becomes the divisor and dividend is the divisor of the previous step, that is 42. And so again, 35 ones are 35, and we are left with 7 as the remainder. So now for the next step, 7 becomes the divisor and the previous divisor becomes the dividend in this step. So 7 fives are 35, and then we get the remainder to be 0. So now we can no further divide it, and at this stage when the remainder becomes 0, the divisor is 7. So HCF of 455 and 42 is 7. So you can see that both are same. But now we'll keep the prime factorization method aside and try to understand and analyze the long division method to find the HCF, so that we can deduce the generalization of Euclid's division algorithm. Now, so finding the HCF by Euclid's division algorithm. So we all know that Euclid's lemma can be applied to any long division at each step. So for the first step, if we recall, for any two positive integers a and b, there always exists two more integers q and r such that a is equal to bq plus r, where r is smaller than b and greater than or equal to 0. So when we apply this statement of Euclid's lemma to the first step of this division, we get step 1 to be 455 is equal to 42 into 10 plus 35. So this is the first step. Now in this step, our remainder is still not 0. So we'll continue it further to the second step. So our step 2, now you can see that slowly and gradually, as we are repeating the steps, the same step again and again, we are actually deducing algorithm. So step 2 will be 42 is equal to the divisor 35 into the quotient, that is 1, plus remainder, that is 7. Again, the remainder is still not 0. So we get back to the procedure step once more. So we repeat the step of Euclid's lemma. So in the step 3, we get the dividend, that is a, is equal to divisor into quotient, that is 5, plus the remainder 0. Now in the third step, when we applied Euclid's lemma, our remainder was 0. So at this stage, whatever is the value of the divisor becomes the HCF. Therefore, at r equal to 0, divisor is equal to 7, which implies HCF of 455 and 42 is 7. Basically, in your board examination, you are going to be evaluated for these steps only, not for this work which is done. This is for understanding, and this can be your rough work because it makes it easier for you to find out the HCF by long division rather than trying to mentally do this, these various steps. So do it as a rough work and this will be your main work. So I hope you have understood the specific example. Now let us try to deduce division algorithm in generalization using the understanding of these various steps. So in general, Euclid's division algorithm will be the HCF of any two given positive integers, say C and D, where C is greater than D, follows the below steps. So what was your first step? So in this first step, step 1, we apply Euclid's lemma and find two whole numbers. Why did I say whole numbers? Because we are also looking for a zero as the remainder. So we find two whole numbers, say Q and R, where R is the remainder. It has to be zero also at some stage, such that C is equal to DQ plus R, where R is smaller than D and greater than or equal to 0. Same as the statement of Euclid's lemma. Just that in this case we have a different value for A and B. So this is the first step. Now in the first step, if you don't get a 0, so what are you going to do? You are going to continue in the second step. So step 2 is continue. If remainder is not equal to 0, we will continue to apply division lemma to D and R. Why D and R? Because this is the remainder of the first step and this is the D for the first step. So with these two numbers, we are again going to apply Euclid's division lemma to the next step. So we'll continue this way. And how long are we going to continue? Till the time we get the remainder to be zero. So continue the process till remainder is equal to 0. At this point, when the remainder is 0, the value of the divisor is your HCF. So continue the process till remainder is 0. At this stage, the value of divisor is the HCF. So I hope you have understood the concept of Euclid's division algorithm now and found it useful. In the next video, we are going to take up the concept of fundamental theorem of arithmetic. You can also follow me on Instagram for my posts on many teaching learning related issues, which I post from time to time with the hashtag experiences of a school teacher. The link is in the description below. Until next time, love and enjoy the beauty of mathematics. Bye.